So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. They come out here in the eye. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three. So second down, 3 yards to go now. Carry here for their fullback, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Well, after that pickup of a first down, I think some of the defensive guys are going to be looking over their coordinator and saying that was not in the scouting report. That went against every tendency most teams have. You don't usually hand the ball to your big guy in that situation. Sometimes you catch them by surprise. This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
20, 35.
They'll try and run with their fullback, and he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Well, not a lot of flash and dash on that play. Second and two, and they hand it to the big man, and he ends up picking up a first down. A little bit of gray area there, though, but I think what they thought, hey, we hand it to him here. If we come back and don't get it, we still got another down to try and pick it up.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because, really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
The wideout, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. Third down here.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9, and they need 10 yards out of it on third. Throwing is Brady on third down. And he will find his man. That's Hogan complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Well, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys? And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. LeGarrette Blount with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. So the offense now dealing with a 2nd and 7. Second down, Prescott surveying the field. He's got the connection to Cole Beasley and able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. It goes as a pickup of 23. And that leads to a Dallas first down.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
It'll go as a gain of 12, and the Cowboys are going to get a first down. So the offense has it first and 10.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want. But you...
And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Jason Witten from 19 yards away, and the Cowboys have broken the tie. Bailey now for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Patriots offense now. They work their way back onto the field, and they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure, we'll see if they dial it up this drive. A good pickup there, a 22. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And now a first down following that long gain. From midfield, here's Brady. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the linebacker, Sean Lee. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. Here's Prescott. Oh, the ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
Brady again here on second and 10. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Brady now to throw. And this is caught. It's Edelman. They convert on third with a gain of 22. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now Brady again. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception picked off by the linebacker, Sean Lee. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Let's get out of there.
We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Prescott. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
There's Kaprish to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, a flat-out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
Here's Prescott. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. They'll get 19 yards there, and it'll be a Dallas first down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
They'll set up the screen to Elliott. A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Come on, let's go!
Prescott yet again. On the left side, he finds Beasley. And down inside the 15 he goes.
As the field starts to get condensed, the defense likes that a lot because now you don't have as much space to cover, but a well-run corner route there.
From the red zone now, Prescott. This will be caught just inside the 10. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One of the selling points at the end route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
Here's Elliott, and that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football,
and he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know, at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script? What, Garrett Blunt? He's at the 40, the 20, and all the way in. Touchdown, New England. LeGarrette Blount, 75 yards. And the Patriots have cut it back within a score. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And he nearly broke that for more, but as As it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they got to try something, because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
On second down, Elliott. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Come on, let's go!
Prescott on third and two. Complete to Jason Witten. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
It fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add it a little extra deep.
And Dez has got it. Dez Bryant for the Cowboy touchdown. Dez Bryant, his second touchdown of the night. And the Cowboys will extend their lead.
Sometimes when I see these types of plays executed, I think of basketball. Guys boxing other guys off to go out and get a rebound.
And he got the rebound right there. But the defense was really placed well.
Yeah, they were right there. I mean, that's where it's really tough for a defender. When you're in the right spot, you're draped on the guy catching the ball, yet he still comes down with it.
So the Patriots coming out now. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
They come out here in the eye. They start on the ground here with Blunt. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
And ready now for second and nine. Brady to throw on second down. He's got a man complete. A very solid gain of 27. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gaudens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like. Like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
Back now in Arlington, it's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. And some extras coming up on the line here, Redding for the blitz. Now a carry for Blunt. And he's going to get this inside the 30. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Most players will tell you that night games, while they can be fun, they're really hard to prepare for. Because you wake up on game day, all you want to do is get to the stadium and let's get going. But you got to bank that fire a little bit and hold it until the evening. It's almost like a Broadway premiere. Got to wait until the nighttime to go out there in front of the bright lights. And boy, has he harnessed himself really well, and now he's unleashing it on the opponents.
On second down, here's Brady. And this is caught. It's Edelman. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They come out here in the eye. Here's Blunt, and he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
He's had a big game tonight, and while no one's going to be overly concerned about that last play, you also know that the offense coordinator does not want to see that happen again. They want to get back to doing what they've been doing all game long.
And he is in. Touchdown, New England. It's the fullback. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots are back within a score. Well, it was second and goal. You're in there close. That's the fullback's comfort zone.
Not only is it his comfort zone, it's an expectation. That's what he's supposed to do. Turn and hand it to him. Big guys fire out. Find your way into the end zone.
Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. Solid return. Pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. One man in the backfield, Ohio, Elliott. They go play action here on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Throwing again, Prescott on second and 10. And incomplete. Cole Beasley, the intended target, and it's third down.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Let's go!
On third down, it's Prescott. He completes it to Bryan. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
How many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And they give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Here we go!
A second down throw for Prescott. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he's brought down. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. There were a couple holes there, partner. Was that zone coverage?
That's exactly what it was, Brandon. When you see man-to-man, that defender runs with the receiver. In this case, they were just taking care of their zone coverages, their responsibilities on the field, and the offense found the open space.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Time is starting to run out, really becoming a factor. We'll see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back to the offense. Second down, Prescott. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in the second half. Instead, it's third down. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. Third and 5. Prescott to throw. And that's caught by Beasley. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
First and goal. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys.
Engage and laugh about what just happened. apples, get sent to mammies. Is that too graphic? Catch you in traffic, you sitting dapping like stealing candy. My ceiling's absent, my wheels are massive, my friends assassins, all of us. Our mothers queens and our women dancers. My rivers rapping, my fin is splashing, my gills are flapping. I bit some matches, then sip some something and kiss the dragon.
I'm really rapping, no fingers snapping, them packing. Slipping, my swag is dripping, so here's a napkin. What's really happening, verbal attacking, I'm showing passion. Know what I mean, see, I'm the king, like I'm from Akron. I'm going overboard, somebody call the captain. And when it comes to getting checks, I always want the fat one. I'm so, I can sing to a chandelier. My flow a glass of spade and yours a candle.
Too many buttons, not enough. These fucking the spot is coming. Shoulder, no shoulder.